Well, good day everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. Welcome back to my channel. This week we're going to talk about atmospheric perspective in compositing, and basically it is just how we see objects as they recede into the distance. As you can see here on the desert photo, it's very sharp in the foreground, but as you recede we lose a lot of clarity, we lose a lot of color saturation. This is another photo here that really demonstrates this atmospheric or aerial perspective. As it recedes into the background, we lose all that clarity and also color saturation. And you'll see a lot of artists use atmospheric perspective as they do their paintings to create depth. But we're going to use this method of atmospheric perspective in our composite today as we add a picture into the background of another photo. So as usual, let's get started. So we're going to use this photo of the desert here, and I'm going to add in the picture of the Millennium Falcon here. So I'm just going to copy the Millennium Falcon over and I'm going to paste it into our desert photo. I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. I'm going to place it in the background like it's coming around the mountain here, coming back into the desert to land. And as you can see, if we zoom in, you can see that the blacks of the Millennium Falcon don't quite match the colors in the background of this photo. So we're going to try and use a blending method that I'm going to show you today to try and make the Millennium Falcon look like it belongs in this photo a little bit better. So on my background here, I'm going to click on the background. I'm going to grab my brush tool, make sure I've got opacity and flow and hardness, 100% for opacity, 100% for flow and hardness, 0. So on my background picture here, I'm going to grab my color picker. And I'm going to pick a relatively dark color next to the Millennium Falcon here. So I'm going to pick it around about here where this picture is darkest. And I'm going to activate that color. And then I'm going to add a new pixel layer on top of the Millennium Falcon here. So on this new pixel layer, I've got my color that I've sampled, got my brush. I'm just going to paint over all over the Millennium Falcon till I've covered it completely with my paintbrush here. So it's sort of getting that same color all over the Millennium Falcon as the background mountain here. So once I've got that painted, I'm going to grab that color and I'm going to clip it to the Millennium Falcon. So it's only just over the Millennium Falcon, just as you see here. And then on that pixel layer, I'm going to change the blend mode to Lighten. And we'll have a quick look what that's done already. If I just turn that off, you can already see that I've managed to make the same colors of the shadows or the darkest colors on the background here match a little bit better on the Millennium Falcon here. So I'll just turn that off for now and we're going to add another pixel layer right on top as well, and I'm going to sample a really light color, sort of like on the clouds back here, and activate that color. And I'm going to do the same again. I'm going to color that all over the Millennium Falcon, because what we're trying to do is now match the lighter colors on the Millennium Falcon to the background as well. So let's just color that all over. Again, let's clip it just to the background of the Millennium Falcon. And again, we'll change the blend mode, this time to darken. Let's just have a quick look. And you can see the lighter colors now are now matching the background. And we'll turn on the darker colors as well. And we can have a look now what we've done with the Millennium Falcon. And we'll just zoom out so you can see now that actually matches that background a little bit better. We can also drop the opacity down a little bit if you think that is a little bit too strong. We'll take it down to about 80%. Let's have a look. Not looking too bad. Okay, but we want the Millennium Falcon to look like it's coming around the mountain there. So what I'm going to do is just add a mask. As we all know, we'll get our colors back to default with hitting D on our keyboard. So we've still got our brush. We're going to be painting in black. Let's just zoom in a little bit. Make our brush a little bit smaller with our right and left bracket keys. And let's just paint that mountain back in just over the top there and zoom out so it looks a little bit like our Millennium Falcon is coming around the mountain. Now one more little thing that we can do, we can add another pixel layer on top of that. We can then sample that color just around the Millennium Falcon again, activate that. We can drop our opacity to about 40% and our flow to about 40%, and just take our brush, make it a little bit bigger, and just on our new pixel layer on the back back of the Millennium Falcon here, we can just paint over that color a little bit so it looks like the back of that is just receding into the background. Again, let's clip that to the Millennium Falcon so we can see exactly what it's doing. So there's our before, there's our after. So let me know what you think of this method, guys. So I've got one more method to show everybody using another type of blending mode, and we'll get rid of our Millennium Falcon here and delete that. Let's bring over an elephant. Now this is very strange, I know, but let's copy the elephant and come over here to our desert photo and paste the elephant. Let's make him a little bit smaller, and I'm just going to use this line along here as my grounding line. Okay, the next method I'm going to show you is very, very simple. Let's click on the background here. Let's come over here to our rectangular marquee tool and make sure we're on the background, and let's just draw a square around our elephant. And let's copy that, Command C and Command V. Let's place that copy on top of the elephant. You'll see the elephant disappear, but that's okay. And let's go Command D or Escape to get rid of those marching ants. Now on that, this background copy, or the little piece of the background that we've just copied, let's just start dropping the opacity until our elephant starts appearing again. And let's take it down to about 20%, around about 20%. And if I turn that on and off, you can see that we've already started to get that elephant looking like it belongs a little bit better in this background. But as you can see, it's still a little bit see-through. So to fix that, let's, on this background, let's add a Gaussian blur. Let's click on the Gaussian blur and let's start taking that down until we see that the elephant is no longer transparent. About there, looks pretty good, 14 pixels. And let's click off that. So have a look at that. There's before and there's the after. And I think we've just managed to get that elephant looking like it belongs in that background a little bit more. Okay, let's go a couple of little steps further. Let's click on our elephant and Command J to duplicate it. This one, we are going to come up here to our move tool, and let's just move that down to the side and bring it down on the side here. Let's come down here to our effects, add a color overlay and click off that. We'll now come across here to our perspective tool, and we'll just bring that perspective down a little bit flatter onto the desert floor there. That's looking pretty good. Let's hit apply on that shadow layer. Let's bring our opacity all the way down to, oh, let's say about 35, looking pretty good. Let's come onto our move tool. Just let's move that shadow up a little bit, and let's grab our erase tool, still on the shadow layer, and let's just get rid of that little shadow around here. And one other thing that we're going to do to make it look a little bit more realistic again is let's add another pixel layer. Let's get our color picker and let's grab a darker color in the desert here and activate that color. And on the pixel layer here, let's grab our brush and let's just zoom in a little bit and let's just paint that darker color just on our elephant on this side. Let's clip that to our elephant so it only affects our elephant. And let's bring that opacity down a tiny little bit, maybe to about 60. And let's have a look at that. There we go. Let's zoom out. And there we go, everyone. There are a couple of methods to help blend images in composites. We've done the Millennium Falcon in the background, and we've also done the elephant in the foreground using a couple of different methods. So have a go at trying all these different methods in your composites. You can combine both of these methods in the same composite on the same object if you want to, but give it a go. See what you think. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for supporting my channel. Until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.